Hey guys, Titanic Animations here, and today I wanted to do a little something different for my 6,000 subscriber special. If some of you don't already know, you can head over to my community tab on YouTube, and sometimes I'll post updates and ask you guys questions and let you guys ask me questions about what type of video do you want to see me make next, or so on and so forth. And about a week ago, I asked everybody, put some questions here and I'll answer them in a Q&A video that I'm gonna do. So I thought I would celebrate my 6,000 subscribers special by actually answering your questions. So let's jump right in. Question one, why are you making something that's already been made? I'm talking about Titanic Honor and Glory. Well, Honor and Glory are out to make a video game. And I just make videos about what interests me about the Titanic. So I don't really understand the question the way that you framed it here. They're out to make a video game, and I just do videos. So, yeah. Question number two. Even though your channel name is Titanic Animations, do you think you'll ever branch off and do other ships? That's a definite possibility one day in the future. I do have some plans already in the making right now, but I can't talk about what they are. But right now I need to focus on the stuff that I already have planned and I've already started before I can start branching off into other ship videos. Question number three. What do you like most about the Titanic? The overall story, the backstory, the lives people led while they were on board, and the various aspects of the tragedy, both from a human perspective, but also from a mystery perspective. Most people like to come out and say, aha, I figured it out, we finally know what happened. But in actuality, we don't really know, because so much data has been withheld from the public. We just have to trust that people have done their due diligence when it comes to research and presenting us with information, because that information could be wrong. We don't know because the information isn't public knowledge for us to look at. So one thing that people really don't realize is that there's actually very little concrete evidence that we have about the sinking. It's all a big mystery, pretty much. If you dive into it, you can pick one aspect of the disaster, dive into it just a little bit, and you'll start seeing mysteries pop up everywhere. For example, the iceberg collision. Okay, so how fast was the ship traveling when it hit the iceberg? Did it slow down any, if at all, from the time that they changed engine commands? What were those engine commands? Because there's a little bit of contradictory evidence. How far did the ship turn before it hit the iceberg? Did the ship actually strike the iceberg on the side, or did it run over an underwater shelf of ice? How long was it from the time that fleet spotted the berg until the collision? Convention says it was 37 seconds. Some people say it was more like 45. Some people say it was actually around 25 to 30. So you'll start to see these little mysteries pop up, even though people like to say, no, this is how it happened. We don't actually know how it happened. So those little mysteries are what drive me to make my videos about Titanic, because everyone loves a mystery, and everyone loves trying to figure that mystery out. Next question. What got me into making videos on Titanic? Basically, a friend and I were sitting around in a chat room in 2012 and talking about the ship as it sank in real time. 100 years to the day the actual ship sank, but we started to look on YouTube for videos to follow along with, and we couldn't find any. They were all pretty much the 1997 animation, or they were badly done, like SketchUp animations that just blatantly followed the 1997 movie. And so we both naively said, we're gonna make our own animation. And that took us 3 years to make the first one. It came out in 2015, and there's been three revisions to that since, up until 2019, I'm sorry. So, but it all started out as us being slightly like annoyed about the fact that there were no relatively accurate minute-by-minute sinking videos on YouTube that were done in actual real time. They didn't take James Cameron's 2012 final word animation and slow it down to be 2 hours and 40 minutes long. We were both wanting an actual real-time animation. Next question. Can you do a video about what if Titanic didn't close her watertight doors after the collision? I could, but I would need the proper computer simulation software or data that was found after such simulations on that software have already been taken, because essentially it would all be guesswork without that software. I don't know the strength properties of the steel, the weight of the steel, the exact weight of the ship. You would need every single dimension everywhere to be pitch perfect, which I'm not currently capable of making because I don't have all of the intricate little blueprints of the inside of the ship that I would need to make those models. Without that software, which isn't available to the public, by the way, that's like expensive, that would be like Navy software, like military software. So without that software, I wouldn't be able to run those simulations. And I know for a fact that they have run a simulation like that in 2005, I believe, but that data has never been released to the public. Again, it's just behind a non-disclosure agreement. So without getting a look at the data or without getting a chance to run that simulation, I would essentially just have to use guesswork to figure out what the ship would do. And I don't really like to do guesswork at all. So in short, I would love to do that video, but I can't at the moment. The next question is, what references do you use for modeling the ship? A variety of sources. The number one source is always photographs of the ship, because obviously it's photographs of the ship. Next would be Peter Davies Garner's Titanic Model Maker's Manual. That has blueprints in it for just about every single thing you would ever want to know about on the ship. Like, here's a blueprint of a fire hydrant. Here's a blueprint of a window. Here's a blueprint of a bolt. You know, it everything. And I'll throw a link down to that in the description below. Titanic the Ship Magnificent also has some blueprints in it that I've been using. And if you can't afford to buy those books, but you're going to be sacrificing in quality a little bit, Encyclopedia Titanica has free plans that you can download of the interior decks by becoming a member for $10 a month. But again, they don't go super into detail with exterior stuff. It's more about the interior layouts. So you're going to be sacrificing your quality of your models if you use that as your primary source. Next question. What's your favorite color? Red. Thank you. And finally, how long was the Olympic in service? From 1911 to 1935, if I remember correctly off the top of my head, it was somewhere around 24 to 25 years. So, yeah, she had a very long career. Unfortunately, her two sisters were not so lucky. So I had a bunch of fun answering you guys' questions. I'll have to do this again sometime. Maybe when we reach 10,000 subscribers, who knows? But until then, this has been Titanic Animations, and I'll catch you guys next time.